Welcome to Contact. We started a series last week called Enemies Defeated. And today our message is Power to Possess. So tell us about what we're going to possess and where is this power going to come from?
Yeah, so the devil is the one who's defeated and God
He's our enemy.
Yeah, and God has given us the power to possess the promised land that belongs to us in Christ Jesus, which is our inheritance. It's a spiritual inheritance. And what we're talking about in this message is two different kinds of power.
Yeah, so two kinds of power.
That are given to us.
And so this is something that's like a double, the holster, you know, with the six shooters on your hips. You know, God has given us some power.
Two kinds.
To function in this world with something He's already provided for us. So I'm excited to hear about that. Why don't you stick with us and we'll be right back.
Shaken. Nathan Morris is coming back to Faith Landmarks Ministries January 13th and 14th. You won't want to miss any of these power-packed services. Come expecting to be healed, set free, and set on fire for the kingdom. To find out more info, visit our website at faithlandmarks.org. Nathan Morris, January 13th and 14th at 7:30 p.m. at Faith Landmarks Ministries, 8491 Chamberlain Road, Richmond, Virginia.
FLM's Child Development Center is dedicated to the growth, development, safety, and well-being of your children. We encourage you to come check us out or visit our website at faithlandmarks.org/daycare for more information.
With distinctive values and a dedicated staff, VCA sets itself apart from the academic normality and encourages the advancement of both social and intellectual skills. Check us out online at myvcanights.com.
Glory to God. Okay, Joshua chapter 1, verse 1, it says, "Now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying," now if you go back into the book of Exodus, you see Joshua was a young man in Egypt before they were delivered out. So Joshua became like a trainee, I guess you could say. Moses was his mentor. And Joshua at first, you know, he's just a helper. So now, but because he followed, Joshua is now going to be God's appointed leader for this next phase for the nation of Israel. Okay, look at verse 2. "Moses, my servant, is dead." This is God still talking to Joshua. "Now therefore arise and go over this Jordan, thou and all this people, unto the land that I do give unto them, even to the children of Israel." Now verse 3 is an action verse. "Every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses." Now we're going to stop there for just a minute. The account of that is in Genesis chapter 15. Okay, God made a covenant with Abraham. Israel are the seed of Abraham. Okay, and so God had already deeded the property to the seed of Abraham by inheritance. So when they put their foot on it, it already belonged to them by inheritance. But if they didn't go in to possess it, they would be like the ones that died in the wilderness on the other side of the Jordan. They would never be able to enjoy the promised land. Hallelujah. Are you out there? Glory to God. Okay, so now look at verse 4. This is almost like the legal description of the property. He says, from the wilderness and this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea toward the going down of the sun shall be your coast. There shall not be any man able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not fail you nor forsake you. Be strong and of good courage, for unto this people shall you divide for an inheritance the land which I swear unto their fathers to give them. So they were on the outboard side of the promised land with the Jordan River dividing them. Joshua led them up to the Jordan River. God parted the river supernaturally. They went forth over to the other side. Okay. And every place that they put their foot was already given to them by inheritance. So they started possessing. Now, a major thing of importance is it took power to do that. Okay, last time I checked, you and I are not the ones that divide rivers. Neither were they. So they had the power to possess. They also had the authority to possess. See, God granted them the deed by inheritance of the property. Go ahead and say amen. So they had authority and they had power to possess. Now, the New Testament tells us particularly about this episode with the nation of Israel. The Bible calls that a type and a shadow for us. Now, so we're encouraged. We're told in the New Testament that we should not fail to possess like some of them did. Now, the ones that crossed over was the younger generation. They were just kids, the younger people, when they left Egypt. But their parents in the wilderness had decided they were unable to possess the promised land. They were in unbelief. They denied the power of God, giving them the ability to do things that were supernatural. Because, you know, the giants are there. Okay, and for the record, you know, the nation of Israel, there was a lot of them, but they were all slaves. They had no idea of, they were not an army. They didn't have weapons. You know, they were not swordsmen and things like that. But in the promised land, all of them were warriors. So on the face of it, it did look impossible. But if they believed, they would be able to receive. So what you see happen, you know, this younger generation, they're still not warriors. But when they cross the Jordan River by supernatural power and enter into the promised land, the nations that were occupying, they started shaking in fear by the power that was displayed. Now, because it's a type, you should understand this. You have an inheritance. It's granted to you by promise. Okay, it's been yours from the time, actually the Bible says from before the foundation of the world. But at Calvary is when the deed was signed in Jesus' blood. And you now have an inheritance, but we're going to find out from the New Testament, it's not a physical land. It's not corruptible. It's eternal, reserved for you to possess it. But exactly like them, this is what the New Testament teaches us. The promise stands, the inheritance is ours, but you do have to go in to possess it. So you could say by type that crossing the Jordan River is salvation, but many Christians have been led into salvation only to stop just inside the river. And many, many of God's people are waiting now in the promised land, but not possessing what belongs to them. The whole rest of the land is there. Now, for the record, Joshua led them forth, and there were some, you know, snafus and things that happened that weren't supposed to happen. But they kept using their faith, and they moved forward, and in one generation, in 40 years' time, they possessed the entire property. Okay? So they did actually go in and possess. Now, so what God is admonishing us to do, the body of Christ, is don't just cross to, you know, the land on the other side. By the way, when they got on the other side, the manna stopped. So then they were obligated in a way to go ahead and possess so that they'd at least have something to eat. Are you there? So what God wants his people to know, how many of you are his people? Okay, he wants his people to know he doesn't want you hanging back and not possessing. Your inheritance, now you should understand, in case you have a problem with this, you're not taking it from anybody. Okay? So your salvation is granted to you as a gift. The one right beyond that is the baptism of the Holy Ghost. You're not taking anything away from anybody to receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Healing is one of your promises. Okay, you see the point? You get to prosperity, people say, oh, well, you know, you're taking money. No, you're not taking money away from anybody. See, when God prospers you, he's got enough to prosper you without somebody else being faulted. I mean, you know, let's get beyond all that. Hallelujah. And the other major one of your inheritance is authority over the devil. Certainly not hurting anybody by that, are you? Amen. Come on, can you say amen? Amen. So once we're in, then God wants us to take his word, which provides faith, to go in and possess the inheritance that belongs to us. It's sitting there waiting for you. Turn with me over, if you would, please, to Peter, 1 Peter chapter 1. Glory to God. God is good. Five basic things. Now, there's a lot of subtitles and subdivisions to these promises, but there's five basic things that belong to you in Christ Jesus. First of all, your salvation. The baptism of the Holy Ghost is called the promise of the Father. And in Acts chapter 2, Peter preached that the promise of the Father belongs to everybody that is called. Now, that means it's not for the world. It's for the kingdom. It's for the church. It's for you. If you're a Christian, then the baptism of the Holy Ghost belongs to you. Now, the baptism of the Holy Ghost, let's just, people, you know, oh, does that mean I have to speak in tongues? Let's get past the tongues thing for a minute. See, forgive me, this is going to sound a little blunt, but without the baptism of the Holy Ghost, you're going to remain stupid. Is that too blunt for you? So if you've been stupid, you'll stay stupid. What do you mean by stupid? Doing the same mistake over and over again. Failing at the same thing that you've been failing at. Is that too blunt for you? Are you tired of failing? Then don't resist the Holy Ghost. Because he's going to lead you and guide you into all truth, which is the Word. And by revelation of the Word, you're going to be able to exercise dominion in your life and apply all these things. We're not bright enough spiritually. See, mankind can be intelligent scientifically in all ways about this realm. But mankind doesn't know about the things of God. The natural man does not understand these things. So without his help, we're stupid. But when you receive the Holy Ghost, he becomes your teacher and your guide, and he leads you and guides you, and he knows all of your little things. You know, about the way you walk. And he knows what it takes to talk to you as an individual where I certainly don't know. Your spouse doesn't know. That's the reason why you're still arguing. Come on now. Come on and say amen. See, marriages don't work without revelation. Ooh, I'm glad I came to church today. Are you out there? Hallelujah. So you need the power of God. You need healing. Ooh, forgive me if this is a little blunt for you, but, you know, if you've been to a hospital lately, no offense, you see what the healthcare system of the United States has come to. That's the best man can do. Don't get mad at me. I'm just pointing out the existence of the condition. I go to hospitals all the time to help people out. I'm stunned that the lights are still on. Ooh, thank you, Lord Jesus. I was telling this woman the other, I was in there helping somebody. I was telling this woman, you know, you guys are not writing anything down. There's all these hallway conversations. You have no record of what you're doing. I said, when we take our dog to the vet, at the end of the day, they do a printout on what they found and then what they recommend and then what they prescribe. And I said, you have never even given us a sheet of paper. That's the reason why there's five different interpretations right in this room of what is supposed to happen. Oh, come on now. Are you out there? So, hallelujah. Healing is something that we should believe in. Woo, go ahead and say amen. Okay. So 1 Peter chapter 1, look at verse 3, Peter speaking. He says, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again." We're begotten again. "Unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead." Amen. Verse 4, "to an inheritance incorruptible." Now the nation of Israel, when they possessed the promised land, it was corruptible. Meaning it's going to develop a tarnish. It's going to rot. Because it's natural. An inheritance incorruptible means that man can't put his hands on it. Nobody can take it away from you. There's no pilfering. There's no rust. There's no corrosion. Come on. An inheritance incorruptible and undefiled that fades not away. Ooh, thank you, Lord Jesus. God is good. People put money in retirement plans only to have it taken away from them. We went to a nation not long ago where the entire retirement is like Social Security was robbed. The whole thing was stolen. It happens to people. Well, how in the world could they do that? Well, men do all kinds of things. Hallelujah. But you have one that fades not away, that is reserved in heaven for you. How many of you are following this? Okay, so we have an inheritance. Now, the book of Hebrews tells us that we should come boldly to the throne of grace through the door. Jesus is the door. There's no other way to get in there. Come boldly to the throne of grace to obtain help. Welcome back again. Really glad that you're with us on Contact. And we realize this is the holiday season. So Merry Christmas and be blessed. Happy New Year. Believe everything is going to work wonderfully in your life. These two kinds of power that are spoken of in this passage, exousia, Greek word for authority, then dunamis is a Greek word that's used for the actual tangible power or the force to do something. So we have the authority to use the power of God, and then we have this actual force that gives us the ability to possess.
Right, and if you don't understand that, you can always just use the name of Jesus. Because that is the most powerful weapon that we've been given on the planet. So what are we possessing? Well, in the Old Testament, they were promised a land, the promised land. Mm-hmm. But in the New Testament, our inheritance, the thing that we want to possess, are all the promises that God has given to us in Christ Jesus. So it's more than salvation. It's peace of mind. It's divine healing. It's the power of the Holy Spirit.
It's prosperity.
All of our needs are met. And so we want, why do we need this power? Well, we need power to we live in a hostile environment. This world is kind of against the things that God has gone to great lengths to give us. And so, you know, we really need to be aware of the price that He paid for us to be able to live in all these divine promises. And then, you know, just receive it by faith and begin to live it. And you know, you just become a person who lives a supernatural lifestyle. People will look at you and say, how are you able to do that on your income? How are you able to just walk away from that disease? I mean, you know, tell me more. Yeah. So that's really what it's all about, that power to possess.
Right. And also here at Faith Landmarks and Contact, we're all about winning souls, and so it takes power to do that. We've been given a commission, which actually gave us authority to go into all the world and preach the gospel. And then every time we step out to go do it, there's dunamis behind it, or power behind it.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're spreading the gospel around the world.
Seeing people get saved everywhere, churches started, Bible schools starting. All of that is that power.
And right under the devil's nose.
Cambodia, Vietnam,
Places where they don't want us to be there, you know, but we're doing it anyway. So the enemy is defeated. So we're spreading the gospel. A few minutes, we're going to show you a video clip that'll give you some more detail about things that are happening around the world. We'd like to ask you to partner with us to spread the gospel around the world by sowing a seed into this ministry, a financial seed. Contact and Faith Landmarks Ministries are good ground. You can find everything that you need to know about this ministry by visiting the website, contact.tv. Follow the links. It'll show you how to do it on the website, but then we also have another way. You can actually give over your phone. So the information about doing that is right there on the bottom of your screen. You can click your way in and actually win souls from your cell phone. So every seed that you sow into Contact supports world missions, our efforts around the world preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ through the Contact broadcast.
Yes, and so during this holiday season, we want you to know how much God loves and cares for you. And we have a special gift for you. Several years ago, Pastor wrote a special book called From Heaven to Earth, and it's about the true meaning of Christmas. And we want to give you a copy for free. All you have to do is give us a call at 866 Faith42, and we'll send you a copy of this special story free of charge. And we also want to invite you to join us for any of our special holiday events. And you can find more information by following the links on our website. Here's a look at what's coming.
Prepare to be shaken. Nathan Morris is coming back to Faith Landmarks Ministries January 13th and 14th. You won't want to miss any of these power-packed services. Come expecting to be healed, set free, and set on fire for the kingdom. To find out more info, visit our website at faithlandmarks.org. Nathan Morris, January 13th and 14th at 7:30 p.m. at Faith Landmarks Ministries, 8491 Chamberlain Road, Richmond, Virginia.
Looking for a place where your child can grow in a Christian atmosphere while you handle the tasks of everyday life? Bring your infant or toddler to our new Child Development Center. Open to kids ages 6 months to 4 years, our qualified and experienced staff provide a loving and nurturing environment that is dedicated to the growth, development, safety, and well-being of your children. We encourage you to come check us out or visit our website at faithlandmarks.org.
With distinctive values and a dedicated staff, VCA sets itself apart from the academic normality and encourages the advancement of both social and intellectual skills. Check us out online at myvcanights.com.
My soul's awakened, taken by all the beauty you bring. You got it blaring, staring, love watching you do your thing. There's no mistaking your style, no mistaking your touch. I see the grand, I see the subtle of your love. Lord, I see you in everything, all day. And every beat of my heart keeps reminding me. I see you in every little thing, all day. No matter where I go, I know your love is finding me. It's finding me in everything, all day.
Again, just really glad that you've been with us today. We believe that the word has been sown into your heart, and God will bring that word to pass, producing a bountiful harvest in your life. So before we go, we also want to remind you that you can contact us for a free copy of my book, From Heaven to Earth. I believe that it'll bless you to know how much God loves you and the entire world. We love you and appreciate you. We'll see you again next time on Contact.